Dave, discuss the pressure traditional finance is under with regards fiat, inflation, central banks, sovereign risk, the unbanked, and ultimately why the younger generation is fed up with the old regimes.
Sure thing, Ash. So in 2020, central banks around the world began printing more fiat. Fiat money is a government-issued currency that is not backed by commodities such as gold. The Fed alone printed and pumped $3 trillion into the economy in a 3.5-month period to June 2020. This money was pumped into the economy by buying bonds and financial institutions. The idea behind putting money into the economy was to drive down interest rates and hope that people and businesses borrow and spend more, and in the process, revive the American economy. While this increase in fiat might have short-term benefits, it is also eroding the purchasing power of the US dollar and other fiat currencies over a longer term period. So basic economics clearly shows that the increase in any money supply causes inflation and reduces purchasing power. The reason for this is because the spike in demand exceeds the supply, causing prices for everything to jump higher. The global increase in money supply, in my view, has been one of the biggest catalysts in 2020 for mainstream institutional investors becoming interested in Bitcoin as a hedge against inflation and a depreciating dollar. There will only ever be 21 million Bitcoin in existence and is thus deflationary in principle, meaning the purchasing power increases over time.
David, how does the expected great wealth transfer relate to cryptocurrencies?
So when looking at the current global system or regimes, it is currently in the hands of baby boomers and members of Generation X. While the majority of these people are hostile to Bitcoin, they will not stay at the head of the current system forever. In the years to come, they'll gradually leave their positions to members of Generation Y, noting there are more millennials than baby boomers who, with the younger generations, are already influencing the rise of Bitcoin. So slowly but surely, in the years to come, we will see the biggest transfer of wealth in history to millennials and Gen Z, thanks to technology and cryptocurrencies, to a large extent. The new generations understand that the current system is unfair. They don't want to have to endure such a disadvantageous system throughout their lives. It is even more infuriating when these all-powerful people at the head of central banks are baby boomers and members of Generation X. A new system must emerge as the current system is broken. The Bitcoin system is therefore the millennials and Gen Z's way out to leave the vicious circle in which the current system wants to lock them in. Since 1971, a purchasing power of $1,000 has lost 85% of its value with the economic crisis that we are currently living in, and the great monetary inflation in which central banks around the world have engaged. The situation will worsen even more. Notwithstanding, the internet has evolved into demand a more efficient digital currency, and the younger generations, most notably the gamers, are well acquainted with the usage of crypto tokens to improve their overall gaming experience.